We're going to try out a little mathematical trick with you today, Brady. It's nothing special, I mean, it's nothing new, but we'll try it out. I'm going to ask you to pick a number between 1 and 30. Don't say it out loud, but pick a number between 1 and 30. Have you done that? Okay.
Yeah. So we'll put it on the screen,
Jack. Yes.
So there it is.
Yeah, great. So we put it on the screen and the guys at home can play along. Okay, so we're going to use Brady's number. I don't know what his number is at the moment, but... I'm going to hold up these cards, and they have numbers on them, of course. If you see your number, let me know, say yes. And if you don't see your number, say no, say pass, something like that. Okay, so let me know.
Yes.
Yes. Do you see your number?
No.
No. Do you see your number?
No.
No. Do you see your number?
No.
No. Do you see your number?
Yes.
Yes. Do you see your number?
Yes.
Yes? Are we back at the beginning?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so in that case, if we're back at the beginning, I can stop. So I should know that your number was 17. Is that right?
Yes.
Yes, right. So now how did we do that? It is an old trick, but if you haven't seen it before, what you do is I know which was Brady's number because I was adding up the numbers in the top left corner. Now look at the top left corners. If I actually do it this way, if I spread out the cards, they all have different numbers on them, but look at the top left corner. Now, if you notice, the top left corner are all powers of 2. Starting from 1, they're powers of 2. So 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. So 1 is a power of 2, it's 2 to the power 0. I knew what Brady's number was going to be because I added on these left numbers for each one he said yes for. So Brady said yes to this one, the red one, and he said yes to this one, the blue one, and he said no to the others. And I knew that I could add those two numbers together, the 1 and the 16, and it added Brady's secret number. Now, the point is, every number can be written as a sum of powers of 2. That's the point. So whatever number you pick, these have been designed so that if you add up the powers of 2, it will give you your secret number. Let me show you what I mean. If I write down the powers of 2, so that does start with a 1 though. I am going to write it right to left. So 2, 4, 8, 16. Okay. And we'll pick a number like, I don't know, 20. Now, which of these do I need to use to make 20? Which do I need to add on? I'm going to use the 16 and the 4. I've written a 1 here to indicate I'm using the 16 and the 4. Don't use the rest. I'm going to write a 0 to show that I don't use the rest. Now, this is binary. This is the famous binary which computers use to count. I'm going to give you a twist to this. I'm going to show you a new way to do this trick, a less well-known way to do this trick. Let's try this out. I've got a new set of cards here. This is a less well-known version of the trick. Same trick. Shall we do it in the same way?
Yeah.
All right, so here's my cards again. You're going to pick a number. Of course, keep it to yourself. But if we can put it on the screen, everyone can play. Have you done that? Okay. Right. So hopefully, we'll do this again. Okay, tell me yes and no when you have your number. Okay, yes?
No.
So a no for that one.
No.
No for that one.
No.
No for that one.
No.
No for that one?
Yes.
Yes for that one?
No.
No for that one?
No.
No for that one. Did you pick 8?
Yes.
You picked 8. You picked this one on its own. Okay. Now, did you notice what the top left numbers were this time? They weren't the powers of 2 this time. Did you notice what they were? They were Fibonacci numbers. These, I can tell you that we can do the same trick using Fibonacci numbers. What I mean is we can write every number as a sum of Fibonacci numbers as well, like we did with binary. Let me try it out. So let's write out the Fibonacci numbers. There's 1, there's 2, there is 3, and there's 8. No, there's 5. Get that right, James. And then there's 8. Then there's 13 and 21. Shall I go up to 21? There we go. Right. Now, let's pick a number. What shall we pick?
19.
19. So I'm going to pick the number 19. What do I need to make 19? Let's use the 13, because that's quite a big number. And wow, 6 now, so a 5 and a 1. So I've written 1s that indicate what to use. I'm going to write zeros everywhere else. And again, it looks like a binary sum. It looks like my binary. It's a binary sum. It uses 1s and 0s, but this time the 1s indicate which Fibonacci number to add together. Using this idea, you can make any number you want using Fibonacci numbers. And if you don't use consecutive Fibonacci numbers, so here I used a 5. Now, I could have used, instead of 5, I could have done 2 and 3. Well, if I don't use consecutive ones, it's unique. So there's only one way to do this. So you can do this trick with Fibonacci, but now I'm going to add an extra twist to this. Because although I don't have the cards for you, I'm afraid, you can do this trick again with prime numbers. Every number can be written as a sum of prime numbers as well. So I'll show you how I made those cards then. Right, and then everyone can make them, because you can make them at home. So I'll use the powers of two cards. I'll show you how to make them. And then if you learn this, you can make your Fibonacci ones as well. I started with the powers of two in the top left corner. Now I said, okay, I've got 1, I've got 2, 3. Well, to make 3, it has to be on this card and on this card, because those numbers add up to 3. So you write down your 3 like that. 4 is here, great. 5, well, how do I make 5? 1 and 4, so I have to write the 5 on the 1 and the 4 card. Then the 6, well, it's 4 and 2. So I have to write the 6 here and here. So let's go back to Brady's 17. As we know that 17 is, well, think about the powers of 2, 16. Plus 1 would do it. And that's why I wrote 17 here on the 16 card, and I wrote 17 here on the 1 card. That's how I made them. Now, the fact that you can do it with Fibonacci numbers is not obvious. It's called Zeckendorf's theorem. It's quite a cool name, but it's actually misnamed. The first guy who came up with this was called Lekkerkeke, and that was his name. That's fun that everyone can enjoy. Lekkerkeke. The prime version of it is also another surprise. And altogether, if you want to know how to do it in general, it's called Brown's criterion. These aren't the only sequences for which this works for, but they're the pretty cool ones.